Hey guys, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video of the most common BMW M54 engine problems. The M54 was produced from 2000 to 2006 and has three variants, a 2.2 liter, a 2.5 liter, and a 3 liter variant. So the M54 is best known for its use in the E46 3 series. However, it is found in a number of other models, including some 5 series, 7 series, the X3, X5, as well as the Z3 and Z4. So quite a few different models, but again, certainly best known for its use in the small E46 3 series. And it delivers anywhere from 168 to 228 horsepower and 155 to 221 pound-feet of torque, depending on the variant or the size of the engine. Of course, the 2.2 liter engine delivering the least power and the largest 3 liter engine delivering the peak of 228 horsepower and 221 pound-feet of torque. So the M54 is also very well known for just being a fun, reliable, and smooth engine. Certainly came from a great time period at BMW where they had perfected the naturally aspirated inline-six engine, and a lot of people ranted and raved about how great these naturally aspirated inline six BMW engines were in that same era. So a lot of great things for the M54. It is a very reliable engine. Despite its reliability, keep in mind it is a 17 to about 24 year old engine at this point. So there is going to be a little bit of extra maintenance and TLC involved in taking care of a 20 plus year old engine. So certainly something to keep in mind that they're not quite as reliable as they were in the earlier days when they were a little bit newer and had less mileage. But we'll circle back to that in the summary at the end of the video. For now, let's go ahead and jump into the five most common problems with the BMW M54. Number one on the list, we have a very simple problem, very common thing for many BMW engines, not just the M54, and that is water pump and thermostat problems. It's pretty common for the M54's water pump to give out every roughly 60 to 100,000 miles. Sometimes you might see a little bit of a longer life, and other times you might not even get 60,000 miles out of the water pump. So something to be on the lookout for. Fortunately, the M54, being an older naturally aspirated engine, is a lot easier than most modern BMW engines to work on. And these parts are also inexpensive. I believe the water pump and thermostat together are roughly $100 or $120 in parts. And again, much simpler to work on than these newer cars, so really not a huge issue. If you take it to a repair shop, you might end up spending $500 or $600 on the repair, but fairly simple DIY, so if you do it on your own, you can save a decent chunk of change, and this repair only ends up being about $100 in parts. Not much else to say about water pump and thermostat failure. If you do notice any kind of overheating or coolant bubbling out of the expansion tank, anything like that, then the water pump is likely on its way out or broken. Minor issue in the grand scheme, and again, something that's common on many BMW engines, not just the M54. Moving into our second issue for the M54, we have the Disa valve, D-I-S-A valve. The M54 uses a dual length intake manifold, which BMW simply refers to as Disa. And that is controlled by a valve that has some plastic components inside, which are the things that tend to break on the Disa valve. That tends to happen roughly around 70 to 100,000 miles and will continue to happen generally around that ballpark if you just continue replacing it with the OEM parts. However, with the M54 being a bit of an older engine, there are now long-term solutions and fixes for this Disa valve problem. So you can find repair kits that use full aluminum parts, full aluminum components, and titanium nuts and bolts. And that really alleviates and eliminates this from being a potential problem that pops up again. So if you do run into that Disa valve failure, check out some of those repair kits with the upgraded aluminum and metal components, and that should pretty much sort you out for the lifetime of the M54. All right, moving on to problem number three with the M54. This is something else that's common on many BMW engines that use VANOS, which is BMW's term for variable valve timing, and that is issues with the VANOS solenoids. So the M54 uses dual VANOS, meaning it has variable valve timing on both the intake and exhaust side, and those solenoids tend to go bad and fail with time. Not really much else to say with this issue. If you look for the genuine BMW solenoids, they are fairly expensive. I think genuine BMW ones can run $200 to $400 for each one. So expensive if you go genuine BMW. However, you can find aftermarket or OEM, just not genuine BMW parts, for about $50 to $100 per solenoid. So a couple hundred bucks to get those new VANOS solenoids. It generally makes sense to replace both of them at the same time. So a couple hundred dollars in parts and a intermediate DIY, not too challenging. If you end up at a repair shop, this can turn into a $500 or more repair job. Certainly could save some money DIYing that, but ultimately not much to say in terms of VANOS solenoids. They're not gonna cause any serious longevity issues or any major concerns, but certainly best to get those fixed if you do run into those VANOS solenoid issues. Number four on the list, another very simple problem with the BMW M54, and that is the positive crankcase ventilation valve, or PCV valve for short. The PCV valve is responsible for venting built up pressure from the crankcase, and over time that just tends to get a little gunked up, and that PCV valve can fail. Super easy fix, very inexpensive, so really not much else to say in terms of the PCV valve, but it is becoming more and more common as these M54s continue to age. Just something to keep in mind and be on the lookout for with M54 problems. Moving on to our last issue on the list here, number five, we have valve cover oil leaks. That stems from the valve cover gasket. Valve cover gasket oil leaks are very common on many BMW engines, especially once you surpass that 100,000 mile mark or 8 to 10 years old. Those gaskets just tend to start becoming a little brittle. They're exposed to a lot of heating and cooling cycles. So that just tends to wear down those gaskets over time, which leads us into a greater topic of the M54, with these being 17 to 24 year old engines. There are a lot of things that wouldn't be fair to consider flaws or true faults of the M54. Issues that weren't common problems for the first 10 or 15 years it was around. However, with that age, again, things like gaskets, seals, O-rings, any kind of rubber or plastic components like coolant hoses, expansion tanks, stuff like that tends to go bad with age. So certainly the M54 at this point in its life and with its current age will take a little bit of extra maintenance and a little bit of TLC just to keep things up to date and keep everything running well. But that's not anything, again, to fault the M54 for. That's just the nature of owning a 15 plus year old engine. There are going to be those random fluky failures that are just age related and not truly flaws or actual issues with the engine. The M54 should have no problem making it to the 200 to 250,000 mile ballpark. Some even make it well beyond that. So to summarize our M54 common problems video, the M54 really doesn't suffer from any major expensive issues. The water pump, again, something that's common on most BMWs, and on the M54, fortunately, it's a cheap and easy fix, especially compared to most modern BMW engines. The Disa Valve, there are long-term solutions for that at this point in time. Otherwise, oil leaks, things that are just related to wear and tear and age on the M54. Certainly a very reliable engine in that sense. Just a much easier and more simplistic engine compared to a lot of the modern turbo BMW engines. So the M54 certainly earns even higher remarks for reliability for that case. Great engine overall, if you keep up with maintenance, stay on top of problems if and when they do occur, but it's certainly reasonable to expect these engines to last well beyond 200,000 miles with proper maintenance and care. Not much else to say in terms of the M54. It might not be the most powerful engine around by modern standards, however, it is still a fun, sporty, and very smooth engine that is also reliable even still to this day, despite being 20 years old. That said, if you guys appreciated this video, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome BMW M54 content. Thanks, guys.